very informal here, which is 35, 35, 40, sometimes 25, 30, 35. I was here on Monday nights, and we study the scriptures in depth. We go into the word, and questions, and discussion, and answers. And so that will be at 6 o'clock. Praise God.
You want to receive the offering?
Yeah, we're going to get the offering here. Did you ever see a preacher that would go without getting an offering? Not this one. I want to thank you for your giving. We do it entirely different than, and you can see we don't put it at first. We don't try to be desperate about the offering before God has His way. But just freely give.
Praise God.
Freely you've received, freely give. And you'll never outgive God. You can't outgive God. You just can't. So if it's a penny, it's a widow's mite, if it's an abundant offering. And we could stand a good offering tonight. I'm not going to stand here and barter. And I never have been an auctioneer in the pulpit. We'll give 10, 10, 10. We'll give 15, 15, 20, 25. Right here, 30, 30, 40, 40, 40. Not that. No. I want you to give from your heart. Give out of your spirit. And come and give freely. God will bless you for giving your tithing, your offerings, and a special offering if you have it to give. We have a little over $2,600 in the building fund, I believe. Maybe a little more than that now. And we're reaching up enough to get our drawings ready for our... We need a youth building here for our young people. Brother Butch said he was interested in the young people today. And I'm getting ready to give someone the design the Lord put in my mind for it, architect, and move forward and see what God will do for us in that building. We're just going to let the Lord lead and guide in that. And so if you have anything to put in the building fund, there's some envelopes right there. And you can do that. Sister Kelly, did you have a request?
Yes, I have a prayer request. My 80-year-old mother-in-law is going in the morning for surgery. Her stents in 6 months have clogged up again, and they're going to clean them out, and they're going to put in some new medicated ones to where it's a new procedure that they do. But she's been having some bleeding ulcers and some different issues, and I pray that please pray for her.
Mother-in-law,
yes,
again, in our
lane,
80 years of age.
And I have another one. My sister-in-law just went to the doctor on Thursday. Her pancreas, her liver, her stomach, and her gallbladder are all swollen. They've done tests, and we're waiting on those to come back, but I know God can...
God can. Lord, you heard that need, that request. We pray in the name of Jesus for that and all the rest of these requests, Lord. Every one of them. Praise God. I might mention, somebody else had their hand up out here.
Over here,
Sister Michelle. All right, Byron.
Yeah.
All right.
And me also, I was in ER Friday. My sugar was 512, and they want me to. It's nothing else wrong, but they don't commit to figure out what's wrong. But I just need involving my kidneys.
All right, and Byron, he's been attending service. Let's remember Byron, and then her sugar. Did you say 512?
Yeah, they wanted a kidney, and I said
goodness. Well, she has the sugar, and Sister Terry's hand. Her blood pressure's been running above 200. And she needs a touch from God. The doctor did not want her to leave the office the other day. And I believe God can help Sister Teresa. I believe He can help her. We all know that's highly dangerous. God help you, Sister Teresa. God watch over you. And this sugar,
God bless our
let's pray for one another. Pray for Brother Matthew Knopf and Brother Stewart here. They have to be going up to New Jersey. When are you leaving, Matthew? Wednesday? To finish that job they have under contract up there. Pray that they'll finish it, get back home, and it'll be through, said and done. God can help them. And then one last request I have is men of our church that need work. We have several men in our church that are available for jobs, available for work. And if you'll let us know in the church office, we'll get to these men. Jimmy needs work there, I know. Some of you other men there are needing work. Glenn's needing work back here. And so anyone that knows of a job available, maybe some of our sisters is seeking work also, just let us know in the office of the church. Amber needs work over here. And I'm not sure if Mike's working steadily now or not. But anyway, let me know about jobs. We need jobs. And so we're honored to have each one of you. We're going to give our offering up. Say again how I'm always honored to have Brother Earl Knopp. And I say that not as a matter of politics. He and I are friends. More than that, we're brothers in Christ. And we let nothing separate that. Nothing. He's a zealous man of God. He loves God. He is a faithful pastor of Suncoast Christian and Venice. And I really appreciate him coming and being a part of the fellowship of this church. Whatever you have to give, I hope it's a bountiful offering. I've always said a preacher likes to see that offering box pop up and say, I'm full. You know, but however it is, why the Lord bless you as you come and give. Praise the name of the Lord, and God bless you. We'll do that. No, don't leave. Just go back to your chair, and we'll leave in unison. We'll leave together. We'll leave with our hands lifted and our hearts praising Him. Praise the name of the Lord. All right? All right? Praise God. Come and give as God has given to you. going to prosper in the Lord, every one of you. God loves you, and He'll make the way where there is no way. Praise God. I start talking to folks, inviting them, and getting them ready for the meeting coming up the 27th. We're expecting a tremendous end of the month, but I don't think it could be any greater than tonight, because God has certainly given us help here tonight. Amen, amen. Turn to your neighbor and look at them and say whatever you want to say. Amen. Say something.